today's show, social psychologist Jonathan Haidt on how politics got so tribal.
Our minds, our thinking, our reasoning did not evolve to help us find the truth necessarily. They evolved to help us adapt and survive in the complex social worlds that we're in. And those worlds are very structured by relationships and teams and intergroup conflict. Our prime directive is not find the truth. Our prime directive is stay popular, manage your reputation. Don't get on the wrong side of the powers that be.
On the value of diverse viewpoints for teams and communities.
If everybody in a community shares the same politics, I can guarantee you they are not able to think clearly about a complex issue. They will be experts in certain aspects of it, but they will be completely blind to other aspects of it. And that is why you need, in certain areas, you actually need a kind of an adversarial system, or at least you need other people who can challenge your confirmation bias. They don't share it.
How schools, universities, parents, and citizens can do something about it.
We have to educate for this complicated hybrid democratic republic. And part of that is going to be, I think, educating for some sense of moral and intellectual humility, that you don't know everything, that your group can't possibly know everything, that we're all deluded by motivated reasoning and confirmation bias, that we actually need engagement with people who are different from us to improve our own thinking.
Plus, some of the research he's been doing on technology, anxiety, and depression.
It turns out that the number of hours that one spends on a screen every day does not predict depression or anxiety. Screen time is not the enemy in terms of depression and anxiety. Social media is, and it is overwhelmingly for girls. So this, does it lead to depression in boys? Maybe a little bit, but it's not so clear. For girls, across different kinds of studies, it's pretty consistent.
All that and much, much more on today's episode of Point of Learning.